is day two of Vlogmas and I've had the slowest start to my day. I think it was really needed after working the last few weeks through the weekends, late into the nights. I've been really, really busy because I wanted to get those shop updates done and all shipped out by the 1st of December, which I did, but I'm really feeling it today. So I had a really cozy morning. I sat in my chair and I knit a few rows of the Cozy Knitter Advent sock. So I'm just on the cuff, but I'm really happy that I've got it started. I'm trying to get used to the 9-inch circulars. I'm not sure if I'm gonna love it. So far it's okay, but I also have a bit of a sore hand. I have a cut on my thumb that is super sore. I'm really hoping it's not infected because it's been really bothering me and I've been treating it and soaking it, so I'm taking good care of it, but it's not the easiest to be working with my hands right now. So I took some much needed time. I think I'm actually going to do quite a bit of that today. I want to catch up on a few things around the house, in the kitchen. I kind of want to bake something for the boys. I've got to start thinking about Camden's birthday, which is Friday. I have an idea, but it's going to take some organizing. And I am starving. It's late, and I think I'm going to head into the kitchen and make myself some breakfast. I have been thinking about oatmeal with berries ever since watching Christina on the Chelsea Yarns Vlogmas last night. I'm so happy that she is doing it. I watched so many Vlogmases really late in bed last night and first thing this morning. I am so happy. It is so much fun to watch some of my friends and all of their December traditions. So I'm gonna go in the kitchen. I'm gonna make that oatmeal courtesy of Christina for Glenn and me, and the boys have eaten. So let's get this day going. Actually, before I go into the kitchen, I am going to show you some of the new ornaments that I added to my tree this year that are bringing me so much joy. So I went back to my favorite store for Christmas ornaments, which is Canadian Tire. And it's where I've gotten most of the ornaments that I've added to the tree in the last few years. And I feel like I've been eliminating some of the older ones. So I'm really happy with the tree this year. I got a new skirt and let's see, I got these cute little wreaths, these beautiful bells. I got these, I don't know what you call them, but I got the circles or the balls, and then I also got these kind of cone shapes and these ones. Oh, and I got these beautiful little clip-on mushrooms. They only had two, so if I can find some more this year, I might pick them up. I think it is super pretty. And all of it is from the canvas range at Canadian Tire. Most of my other ornaments are also from there, and especially these. These are some of my favorites, and these come in boxes, so you can kind of get quite a few of those for a really good price. So that is my updated tree this year. And I also added the beautiful snowflake ornament that my friend Cherie sent me. I had a great comment last night after day one. Someone suggested that I should put her name and the year on the back of it, and I think that is brilliant. So I'm going to do that today. I decided to make a run to the grocery store because I need one or two things that we are almost out of, and this particular store has pajamas, and I kind of want a new pair of Christmas pajamas. It's just one of those days. I love cozy flannel pajamas, and I know I'm going to have a pair under the tree, but I really want a pair to wear right now. So James is coming with me. We are gonna go get just a couple of things at the store, get back, and relax for the rest of the day. I'm back from the store, and I found exactly what I wanted. I got these new pajamas. I saw this adorable Santa cookie jar. I couldn't resist. And James came with me, and we found the candy cane ice cream that comes out every winter at the superstore. It's President's Choice. And we also found these ice cream sandwiches. So I'm gonna put everything away, wash my pajamas. I'm just gonna warm up my leftover pizza from last night for lunch. And I'm going to sit down and try to do some knitting this afternoon. And James tells me there is a soccer game, so I'm gonna sit with him and watch that a little bit later. So I was just eating my pizza for lunch, and I realized if I don't figure out dinner soon, we may be ordering pizza again tonight. So I started to defrost some chicken breast this morning, but I didn't really know why. And I just remembered a back pocket kind of recipe that is super easy and doesn't take much energy. And so that is what I'm doing. I cut up the chicken breasts a little bit because they're still kind of frozen, but that's okay. I have lots of time in the slow cooker. And I'm using a recipe for a honey garlic chicken that I found. I can never remember the website that it's on, but I will put the link below because this is such an easy and simple recipe, and it's perfect for days where you just don't know what to make. And so we will have honey garlic chicken. I will put some rice in the rice cooker and maybe steam some broccoli with it, and dinner is complete and done. And I'm gonna sit for the rest of the day. So you basically just make a little marinade with these ingredients. There's rice vinegar, soy sauce, honey, tomato paste, and garlic. I'm gonna mix this up and pour it over and cook it on high for 3 or 3.5 hours, and that should be it. I'm just about to put the rice in the rice cooker and pull the chicken out of the crock pot for dinner. But I spent a few minutes just relaxing and trying to do a few rows on the cuff of my Advent socks. But I'm kind of stuck because I am using the 9-inch circulars, which isn't too bad. I don't mind it, but I don't think it's making for very efficient knitting on the cuff. I think once I get to the knitting portion, it'll be much faster, easier to manage. But then I realized that for some strange reason, I did a 1x1 cuff, and I never do that. So it's actually taking me a really long time. I'm not enjoying it, and I'm kind of wondering if I should just rip it out and get these cuffs done on DPNs nice and quick so that I'm ready to go with the stripes. I'm not really in a rush, but I would love to get past the cuffs so that I can just do a stripe or two each day. So I think that's my dilemma. Unfortunately, I think I'm going to rip this out, restart it, and also maybe take a look at my knitting projects for the month. I do have some sleeves I want to finish, and I might pull out some of my knitting tomorrow and share that with you then, because it's getting dark and I'm still super tired It's been a really good day of just kind of giving myself a break. And so I'm gonna put dinner together. I'm gonna get my new pajamas on. They are just finished in the dryer right now. And I think I'm gonna put on a Christmas movie and just relax. And then tomorrow I'm going to reassess the knitting, pull out any projects I wanna work on, and maybe put away a few that are not inspiring me and they're kind of clogging up my brain space. So that's where I am at with my knitting. The chicken looks and smells amazing. I'm just going to slice it up. I've got the rice in the rice cooker. I've washed my cookie jar and I was just gonna put some cookies in it. I really like these. And I pulled these out because I recently rediscovered these. I had remembered having these really delicious orange chocolate covered cookies or wafers when I was really young. And I had forgotten all about them. Then I thought about it recently and I asked my mom and she couldn't remember what it was. And of course I asked my sister Kathy and immediately she said, yeah, those are club bars. And I went on a little hunt. I found them in the British section of the grocery store and they're exactly the ones I remember from my childhood. My mom used to get them at a bakery, I think, and she had forgotten what they were, but this is definitely them and it is a new obsession. I've got a couple tucked away and so far it looks like only James and I like them, which is a really good thing because if Glenn likes them, there will be none left. So I think this is going to be stashed in a secret spot. I'm gonna fill up my cookie jar and get dinner ready for the night. Oh, and I also put this tray here because I've been wanting a new tray to kind of collect all of the little bits and pieces on my counter. And I'm just trying to figure out one last piece. I have an idea that I'm gonna put here with some cookbooks and I'm hoping a piece that I have in mind is going to work. It's on its way and should be here any day in the mail. And then I'm gonna finish setting up this little section because I've been obsessed with just reorganizing and switching up my counters lately. I don't know why. Maybe it's because of all the extra time we're spending in our kitchens right now, but I really like it. So I picked up this tray today and I'm really excited to finish it off, but I'm still waiting for one last piece and then I will share it with you.